Hey, I'm Adam Rossen with the Rossen Law Firm, and today we're going to be talking about the 10-day rule and how to get you driving again after a DUI arrest. So a lot of people ask us, can I drive after I've been arrested for DUI? And the answer is yes. You can drive for 10 days. If you look at the bottom of your DUI citation, your DUI ticket, it says that unless you're ineligible, meaning unless you have a suspended Florida driver's license or you're not eligible for a Florida driver's license, then you can drive for 10 days following your arrest with no restrictions. This is not a hardship license. This is not a restricted license. It is a full driver's license for 10 days. Now, this 10-day period where you're allowed to drive falls into what's called the 10-day rule. And what the 10-day rule is, during this 10-day period, if you wish to try and save your driver's license, you have a very important choice to make with the DMV. You have to fill out the DMV's process. And there's basically two different decisions or choices that you can make. Option one is you file for a formal review hearing. That formal review hearing is like a mini trial at the DMV, and they give you a temporary hardship permit, and I'll go over that in a little more detail later. Option number two is you waive your right to challenge the formal review hearing, and you get the hardship for the entire time. But you have to make this decision and pick one of those two options within that first 10 days, and if you don't, then you've waived your right to address or handle either one of those, which is not good at all. When you have a hardship license for a DUI, it allows you to drive for anything that's necessary to maintain your life or your livelihood, or the life or livelihood of somebody who you are a caretaker for, so such as an elderly parent or a young child. It means you can go to and from home, school, work, religion, kids, attorney, groceries, medical. But keep in mind, it has to be direct, meaning you have to go to work and then go immediately home. You cannot go and pick up your coworker who's a friend of yours who just happens to live on the way to work. You can take your kids to school. You cannot take your kids to after school karate practice or baseball practice, because that's not necessary to maintain their life or their livelihood. So people often ask if they need an attorney to get a hardship license. The answer is no, you can definitely do it yourself. But what I can tell you is it is very hard, very difficult to do. When you get arrested for a DUI, there's a lot of things that happen. You've spent a night in jail. You've had to figure out and get a bail bondsman. You're out of jail. Where's your car? Is it at the tow yard? You know, where is it? How much is that? What are you doing? There's all of these things that are going on. And the last thing that you need to do is go to the DMV or go to the wrong DMV, waste 2 hours there, then go to the right DMV and waste 4 hours there handling all of this. So yes, you can do it yourself. You know, when you hire an experienced criminal defense attorney, it's like hitting the easy button. We've done this thousands of times, and this might be the very first time you're ever doing this. So of course, we try to make it easy, fast, and get you back to what you need to do, which is probably get back to work, probably get back to being a good parent or being, you know, a good student in school or whatever you have going on in your life, and not worrying about this. You know, that's what we handle for you. So let's talk about the formal review process. And remember, this has to be done and applied for within the first 10 days after your arrest for DUI. So what we do is we file for the formal review, and it's basically a mini trial at the DMV. There's a $25 administrative fee. We go ahead, we pay that, and what the DMV will give us in return is a 42-day hardship permit. It's a piece of paper with a red stamp. You cannot use it as a photo ID, but that's your hardship for the next 6 weeks or 42 days. Now, by law, we have to have this hearing within 30 days of the date that we request it. We get the documents, we get the police reports, we get the evidence against you. And most likely, we're going to subpoena the officers and the witnesses for this hearing. Most of the time, we don't want our clients to be there. They don't have to be there. We can waive your appearance, and usually it's better if you're not there. And we have this hearing at the DMV. Sometimes it's in person, sometimes it's on the phone. And there's many ways that we can use this hearing to win the hearing and to use this also in your criminal DUI case, because they're separate and apart. This trial at the DMV is completely different than your criminal trial at the courthouse with a prosecutor and a judge. Now, if we win this hearing, then you get your full driver's license back immediately. Remember, it has no bearing on the criminal case. They are completely separate and apart, but obviously if we win this, that's great for you. You can get your full license back, no hardship, no restrictions. What happens if we lose the hearing? If we lose the hearing, then you're gonna have to have what's called a hard suspension period, which is a time that your license will be suspended when you're not eligible for a hardship license. If this is your first time refusing a breath test, that hard suspension period is 90 days. If this is your second time refusing a breath test, there actually is no hard suspension, and it's a full 18-month, year and a half suspension. Now, if you gave a breath test and you blew over the legal limit, there's a 30-day hard suspension. So if we lose this hearing, one of three things will happen. Either you'll have a 30-day hard suspension until you can get your hardship again. You'll either have a 90-day hard suspension until you can get your license or your hardship again, or it'll be no hardship and a full 18-month suspension. So it depends a lot of, you know, we have to go back and see what happened on this case, and if this is your second or third or fourth or fifth DUI, what's happened to you previously.